Okay, hi everybody. I'm making this video to try to help somebody on the over on the Adobe InDesign forums. That's forums.adobe.com, and particularly under the InDesign section. And you can read along with me here. This user reported he's working on a file for 2 days. It was almost complete, and it was tables and text boxes while I was editing a name. All of a sudden, the file crashed and it went to open again. I tried to open the file in the normal way. Yes, recover. No, don't recover and cancel 3 ways. Freeze InDesign, etc., etc., etc. So hopefully Adobe can help them. I mean, Adobe can help people in some instances, but basically what we found is that our method is quick and probably your best chance of getting your file back quickly, if at all. So he or she left a link to the file, and I downloaded it, and it's right here. And what I basically will show you, I tried to open it in InDesign CC 2019. I get that lovely splash screen that I love so much. And it goes through the process, and at first I'm thinking, hey, this is looking positive. It even asks you to update the links. So I click don't update links, hoping that would not, that would, and then boom, you get this crash. And you saw that message there. We'll see what that was in the video. I didn't have time to read it. And it just keeps going. You can't do anything, it's going to tell me in a moment that InDesign crashed. Now, we here at Markzware have various methods and ways to try to fix files. What I always try to do is the simplest way, of course, and that is our application Markztools. And Markztools is a standalone utility that will convert InDesign files into IDML without even opening them in InDesign. You don't even need InDesign on the machine. So, and by the way, another thing I often do I open up ID util, which is just out with CC 2019 support, and I try to drop the InDesign file in there, see if I get a preview. I do. This is a very good sign that we can do something here. Let me see, we don't get all the pages in preview. That's a little bit odd. So there is something odd going on here. But I do appear to get a lot of stories. And all the various images used. So this is a positive sign. We could see it a little bit. But I can't really do anything more than export this. I could get this. I could export the stories out of here. This is a free utility, by the way. But more than that, not really. So the next thing I'll do is I'll try the Markztools, which we were just discussing, Markztools 2. I'll try to drop the InDesign file on there and create an IDML file. And we see we got that warning. That's not a good sign. It's crashing Markztools as well. You see it did try to make an IDML, but I doubt the IDML is complete. I'll try to open it in CC 2019. It's the folder you get with Markztools 2. You'll get a low resolution previews of the images and the IDML file created from the InDesign file. But hey, maybe it worked. Maybe it did. It squeezed out an IDML. So Markztools was able to squeeze out an IDML from this rather corrupt file, as we saw. And there it is. Everything right here. I don't want to show too much. I don't know how what this is exactly. So if I then go and I do save as, and this is how I do it for people in the who I fix bad files for, I'll add a fix to it. I fixed a couple of them here. Then I go and I do file export, and I'll save a low res PDF. So the customer can decide if they want to pay or not. Normally you have to pay for this. I'm doing this one for free to show all of you how we do it. So this is just for preview only. And then I would send this to the customer and say, look, hey, we fixed your file. Do you want to pay the nine? Basically it's about $99 or euros to fix it. We don't ask for that second payment unless it's fixable. And you see it's a very quick process. In this case, it was very easy. You could have done it yourself if you owned Marx Tools 2. It's an application from Marx where you can get on, over here on Markzware.com, and you can get that under products, Marx Tools 2. It's very inexpensive and very handy to have in your toolbox anyway to, you know, create IDML files from any InDesign files you have. A great way for archiving or, you know, saving out files. And we have a lot of other great products like Flight Check and the ID Utility you just saw, which is great for collecting and compressing and everything also without InDesign needed. It's also standalone and will check many different file formats. But there's that ID Util we also showed you briefly as well, which is totally free and you can download on the App Store. So I will now reply on the forum section here, the successful recovery. In this case, I'll get it back to this customer for free because we used it in the demo here. But for the rest, if you need information on our bad file conversion service, actually bad file recovery service, we actually have a conversion service as well. Just go under products and click under DTP File Recovery Service. And you get all the details on how we can fix bad files if you ever come across one as well. I can't do them always for free here. This does cost time. Time is money. And, you know, this case, it was relatively simple. There's many other processes I go through when this doesn't work. And that's a lot of times that doesn't work. And I have to go the next step and other tools and some stuff I wouldn't even be able to show you right here. Some internal tools we have. In any event, that's how we can fix bad files, a brief overview, and I'm glad we could help this customer over on the Adobe InDesign Forum. David Dilling from Markzware, wishing you a fantastic day.